don't do garbage. Three R's: reuse, recycle, and remember to take the garbage out. The most important one. Today's video is a fun one to bring your moods up, and I know the last video was a little bit scary, the title, sorry about that, but today we're gonna be doing something very different. A few days ago, a friend of mine, Ben, hi Ben, reminded me this Photoshop technique called abstract twirl, and you can create it from beautiful photos, from average photos, from ugly photos, and even from garbage photos. Let me show you how. I'm going to open up the photo of a garbage. It's really not about the photo you are going to use. It's about the colors and pattern in the photos, because you will drag those colors, you will twirl those colors to create the abstract. And if you do stock, you can upload the best ones to your stock agencies because they can be sold as digital backgrounds. Here's what I did. You could just use a single photo to create a simple result, but I'm going to go with more dramatic results. So I'm going to multiply the image and create colorful, even pattern. And quick tip, from what I'm seeing, the result looks better if you photograph an object on a little bit darker background. To multiply the image the way I do it, I simply copy the whole image by pressing Ctrl C keyboard. I have to make the canvas bigger, so I'll go to Image, Canvas, move the image to the top left corner, double the sides, and press OK. Now your canvas is bigger. Press Ctrl P to paste the image three more times, move images around. Now I'm going to see if I like the way the colors are spread, and perhaps turn around some of them by flipping the layers horizontally or vertically. Once I'm happy, flatten all layers to create one base image. Depending on the computer you use, you might want to check the size of the photo, because once you're going to be processing all those filters, it might take forever. So for me, I'm actually going to resize it a little bit down. I'm going to use 2000 pixels in width. I'm going to convert the base layer into smart object. What is smart object? Smart object preserves an image's source content with all its original characteristics, enabling you to perform non-destructive editing to the layer. Tongue twister. Now we are going to destroy the photo. Go to filter, pixelate, meta tint, choose medium lines, and now you see more of the colors you are going to work with. Next, go to filter, blur, radial blur, select maximum 100 and change the effect to zoom. I'm also going to choose best quality. Click OK. And congratulations, now you destroyed your photo. And now you know the reason why you can choose any photo to work with. It is all about the pattern. You want those lines very smooth, so you might want to run the effect a few more times. I will do it two more times. So go to filter, blur, radial blur, OK, and again. Now the lines look super smooth and blended. And now is the fun part. It's time to twirl them. So what happens, you will twirl it one way and then you twirl it the other way, and you just have to blend those two layers together by choosing a blending mode you actually like the most. That's it. Go to filter, distort, and twirl. And let's select minus 100. Now we're gonna twirl it to the left, like counterclockwise. Down the road, you can experiment with different numbers to see how much actually you want to twist, how much you want to twirl. So minus 20, minus 50, minus 80, anything goes. The first twirl I'll leave on minus 100. Now press here to select blending. Each blending mode will give you a different effect. I usually go through them all and find which one I like the most. In this case, let's select lighten. And at this point, if you're someone who likes very simple abstract, you can just play with it further with the colors and all that in Photoshop or Lightroom, and you can just save it, you are done. But for me, I'll keep going. And I'm going to twirl it again in different direction and use blending mode I like, and twirl again and use blending mode. And I just continue, keep going until I like the result I see. Once I'm done, I'll just save it, go to Lightroom, because I prefer to go to Lightroom, and just play with the colors, bring the contrast up, maybe change the colors a little bit, play with the levels. I just do a whole bunch of different effects. I literally just play with Lightroom and see what comes out, because with this, you can't really plan ahead. You have no idea what will turn out and how it will turn out. Well, I hope you liked today's video, maybe a little bit different, a little bit out of comfort zone, just to play around with a kid again, but with the computer this time. If you did, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to all future videos. If you have any questions, comments, special requests, you can always leave it in the comment section below. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.